In today's message, we're going to look at some scripture which encourages us to not let go of the things that we have heard before. And today's message is titled Identity and Intimacy. It is said that man has some basic questions, you know, irrespective of whatever background he is from, whatever worldview he or she is from, has some basic questions, or we can say that some basic needs. And some point in their lives, they ask these questions or grapple with these questions and with these needs. So the first one is this, about origin and identity. You know, where did I come from? Who am I really? A question of origin and identity. Or it could be a question of purpose and meaning. Questions like, why am I here? And what's the point of it all? It could be a question of morality. What is right and what is wrong? Is there anything called, you know, right and wrong? And how should I live? And also, it could be a question of destiny. Where am I going from here? When all this comes to an end, or will it come to an end? Is there life after this? And where am I going? And I suppose we could add to that list. And one thing that we could add is a question like, whose am I? Like, who do I belong to? A question of relationship and intimacy. Who do I belong to? A real need, you know, can I belong to a family? Can I belong to this group? And can I belong to something? And so that I can show love and receive love. And I suppose we can go on adding to that list. Now, all these questions and all these needs are fully and satisfactorily answered and met by the Lord Jesus. So we're going to look at three things, you know, three main points, if you want to call it that. So the first one is this, our identity in Christ and our intimacy with Christ are interconnected. 1 Corinthians 6 and verse 17 says, but he who is joined to the Lord is one spirit with him. So that's how close he is to us, and that's how close we are to him. But we might say, you know, I don't feel anything emotionally. That's fine, right? So when we believe the truth of God's word, then the power of God's word begins to work effectively in us who believe. The second thing is, when we forget who we are in Christ, or willfully disregard who we have become in Christ, we make ourselves vulnerable. Vulnerable for temptation, vulnerable to the draw or the pull of the flesh to commit sin. 2 Corinthians 5:17, if anyone is in Christ, he's a new creation. Old things have passed away and all things have become new. When I forget this, I behave and make choices like an old creation. Even though I'm a new creation, even though I'm born again, I go back and make those choices. Why? Because I've forgotten. I've been just seduced by the spirit of the world. I've been just swayed by these things. And I find myself doing it. Why? Because I've forgotten. Or I willfully, intentionally disregard this truth and walk into temptation and walk into satisfying the desires of the flesh. Now, when I forget this truth, this amazing truth, that I've been born again, that I've been raised, I've been made alive with Christ, I'm seated together with Him in the heavenly places. When I forget that, I open the door for all kinds of temptation. And thirdly, just wanted to say that sin offers counterfeit identity and counterfeit intimacy. So what does it mean? It means that my significance and security and self-worth will start to form or be established based on certain other things and not on what I've become in Christ. You know, work is God-given, right? Ministry, work, God has given it to us. But He doesn't want that to become the base of our identity or the foundation of our identity. Our identity is who we are to Him and who He has made us to be. That is really the foundation. All that we have heard, all that we have learned all these weeks, and put it into practice, really apply it and say, you know, this is who I am. Now, I'm going to affirm this constantly and daily. I'm going to meditate on this, and I'm going to acknowledge every good thing that is in me in Christ. And I'm going to believe what God says about me so that, you know, when I believe, I know that the Word of God will work effectively in me. And I'll experience the transformative power of God's Word, which is powerful, alive, and living. Amen.